I'm Samar Singla, and I'm CEO and founder of Jugnoo, which is a ride-sharing app. And we're based out of India. We are the third largest ride-sharing app in India, and we do about 50,000 transactions every day. So we use tuk-tuks to do delivery and rides from A to B. And we're also today at a point where the next step for us is to answer a very critical question that almost everyone in the tech industry needs to think about, at least. Because one of the most important questions is that there's a lot of concentration of wealth which is being accelerated by technology companies. And what is the future, and how do we reduce it? Because people are increasingly not happy with the situation, how very few people control most of the resources. And most of the people don't really have any say in the decision-making of these technology companies. So that's what we want to answer. And we have a few approaches. And I would like to discuss them with you. So all the marketplaces, all the on-demand apps like Uber and Airbnb have essentially been marketplaces. They are based on the promise that free markets are efficient, right? Because there's competition. All the players in these markets are rational, and regulations are not good. So the government should stay out of it and let people compete. And the best player technologically and socially and product-wise will win. But today, that promise is not really being kept, because there is one of the there's one of these things being one of these rules being messed around with. And that is, the players are not really rational, right? In a rational free market, everybody would just try to compete on products, compete on strategy of marketing, compete on messaging. But everybody would essentially work for profits and would try to work for, run a business. But today what happens is companies raise massive amount of capitals, they burn artificially and create monopolies very, very quickly. And then the next step is that they start to exploit the people who work on their platform. So in this case, drivers, right? And after that, once a monopoly is completely created, then the customers are also exploited by increasing the pricing and also increasing the profit margins, which is what capitalism is. But at the same time, competition is essential if capitalism has to work well, right? And that is what is not happening today. This artificial monopoly creation is so fast that many companies don't really stand a chance, right? It's one company, and that grows. So we have thought of a solution, right? That solution is basically having a different type of company, right, which has these three aspects. One is that the company should be decentralized on two levels. One of them is ownership. So essentially, in simple words, what it means is that we want to give ownership to the people working on the platform. So essentially, if it's it's a ride-sharing platform, the drivers on the platform should have ownership in the company, right? And secondly, in the decision-making. So from a ride-sharing perspective, the most important decision is pricing. So the way we think it should work is that every driver should put in their own pricing, and based upon a real-time consensus, a right price should be achieved at. A central authority should not be deciding the price, because a central authority is actually most of the times increasing or maximizing their own profits rather than trying to maximize the liquidity in the marketplace, right? Which is what a group consensus would do. And secondly, we want to make it very dynamic, because today all the marketplaces try to push the participating players into a scenario where they are almost full-time working on that marketplace, because it serves them, their supply is smoother. But that also increases the stress level in those suppliers. So we want to keep it very, very dynamic, so that there should be no commitments of advanced timings. And finally, we want to have it build it into a distributed platform. What it means is that every entity, all these marketplaces, are fairly disjoint companies or entities based upon region. So if you think about London versus Paris, a ride-sharing app in London is completely disjoint from Paris because there is no network effect across these two marketplaces. And you know, one same company in London can be doing really well and can be doing really badly in Paris. So what we feel is that the legal entity should be different in London and Paris, because a company that is only concerned with the business of a particular small geographic region is going to do what is best for that region, right? They should not be thinking about, you know, what the global company would want them to do, right? So these are the three aspects we think if we bring into the model somehow, we can really change how ride sharing is being done today. And this could become a movement which changes how wealth is being distributed across the people who work on ride sharing platforms. So how do we do this? To be very honest, we don't really have a solution yet. We have an approach which we will go forward with, and then we'll tweak as we go along, and we'll figure out what the right solution is probably over the next 1 year or so. So here are the next steps, possible next steps. One of the very interesting possibility is that we make a blockchain-based ride-sharing app which is completely decentralized. The problem today is that it's very, very expensive in terms of energy and computation to really run a ride-sharing application on top of the blockchain platforms that are existing today. So we'll really either have to wait for the platform to mature or just use it partially for something like consensus-based decision-making, not really something else. And the second approach is that we go back to the way taxi companies have traditionally worked as cooperatives, but try to make them tech-enabled so that they are much more inclusive and much more dynamic. And finally, there is the Wikipedia model, so which is basically, you know, have a non-profit organization own all the IP and technology, and that is being licensed for free or for very minimal prices to run the operations and to these local entities. So the way we think of getting started is to build a organization, which is a non-profit organization, globally, and move all the technology into it so that it can be shared with anybody who wants to create something for free. And then have these local cooperative chapters in cities, right? And all of these cities, city chapters, would be autonomous in their decision making, but they'll still depend upon the parent organization for the technology and for simple rules to be followed. So this is essentially taking the Wikipedia model and applying it to ride sharing. So that is what we want to do. And we are going to go live in London by end of January in this approach, and we'll see how it goes. And so one thing that we should mention is that there is obviously a risk in this approach, because it sounds very good, but at the same time, it hasn't really worked so far. The reason for that is, one, maybe people will not like it at all. You know, people will think it's a stupid idea and just forget about it. Second possibility is that the competitors, which are, you know, these companies, existing ride-sharing companies, they start to burn a lot of money and try to make sure that no driver actually gets onto this platform, right? That's the second possibility. And the third possibility is that it actually works, and the drivers cartelize, and we come back to the square zero where actually consumers start getting exploited again by high prices. So I think what we want to do is the first and the second are really the key points where we hope that if people are long-sighted and they want to think about, you know, long-term future, they are going to be interested and on board on this. But at the same time, if people are myopic and they want to really think about the short term and want to make short term money, they'd probably go for the burning companies and not come onto this platform. So it's really just an experiment. It's a social experiment to see if people choose long-term over short-term. And third point, which is drivers cartelizing, that has to be taken care of by us. We have to make sure the rules of the platform are always such that beyond a certain margin is not permitted if you are using the platform's technology. So this is our plan, and let's see how it goes. So I think I'll send you all an update on how it goes. Thank you very much.